Krishna, 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 to?
Helping so much. So nice. It's very beautiful.
Way up high on Govardhan Hill, where Krishna runs with the cowherd boys and Balaram, Vrindavan. Way down low where the green grass grows as your moonlight flows with lotus flowers in her hands,
লাগবে না তো।
কি করব?
রেখে দিয়ে আসবো,
রেখে দিয়ে আসবো,
আমি যাচ্ছি একবার,
না না থাক
আমি আসছি।
জীবতে ভক্তি রে গঙ্গ স্বামী ইতি নামি
ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै प्रदानये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरयाजिहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वो विनेजो तं तवैवास्मि आमि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाने राधे तं नयमाम चरणान्तिके
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल my millions of dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my paramaradhyatam guru pad padma nitya lila pravishtam vishnu pad shishma bhakti pragyan kesa goswami and same millions of dandat pranam in the lotus feet of my shiksha guru nitya lila pravishtam vishnu pad shishma bhakti vedam swami maharaj In continuation, Krishna began to tell to Uddhav the history of Dattatreya and Yadu. He is telling Dattatreya that we have explained before yesterday, and I'm giving something in brief, that from ocean is my Gurudev. I've learned that as ocean, always very gambhir, grave, atha, apar, asim, no limit, no limit, never becomes shuddha,
agitated.
If rain, rainy season, so much rain fall, but not
water not raising high,
and in the
summer
time
season.
Of
summer season,
summer. Water does not go low. So a devotee should be like very deep. That gender people cannot. Oh, what he is thinking? Very deep. And if any calamity, suffering, anything coming, so much happiness coming, if then he is what?
Calm and quiet, not
disturbed. Calm and quiet. Not angry, nothing. If anything good coming, if not coming, in worldly things, if any good thing coming or going, oh, he never becomes very far off. You know Patinga?
Moth.
Means, if in rainy season, especially, if he sees any fire, at once he thinks that very beautiful this, and jumps in the fire and burn forever. We should learn that we should not be attracted to very beautiful form, whether lady or male. Never. Otherwise, he will lose his bhakti and thus his death of paramarthic, transcendental death will be. Always think this, especially sannyasis and brahmacharis, to whom Gurudeva has told, be one-pointed and give your whole affection, energy, everything to Krishna. They should be always alert for this. Otherwise, they will be like Patinga, and they will, paramarthic mrityu will be done. Also he told, those who are mudha, very ignorant and foolish, they kamini kanchan. Kamini, you know?
Women and gold.
And kanchan.
Gold.
Gold. And gahne kapde se saji hui. Decorated by ornaments.
Nice
powder and so many lipsticks, so many things, paints. Those who are attracted, then that is very foolish person. A devotee should be alert from this. Also, yesterday we explained about madhu bee. Don't collect so much, otherwise hunter will come and take you with your
money.
House.
Kya? Beehive.
Beehive. And he will crush and will take you. Be always alert. He is telling that I am always alert. I like Brahmar. Brahman means
bumblebee.
He only takes something, little, a small quantity from all kinds of flowers. And he does not keep it for tomorrow. Never. So we should be like that. Don't keep anything, a sannyasi. They should not keep anything. For tomorrow. And elephant we have told, and then deer. Who will speak about deer? I want that new one should be. Oh, Binda, you can.
Yāna cīmaraṁ dasyā janan jana salakaya chakṣur urnivitam yena tasmai śrī guruve namaha vāṃśa kalpatarūpyāścā kṛpā sindhu vevacā patitanam pāvanebhyo vaiṣṇavebhyo namo namaha. First of all, I offer my unlimited dhamma vatranama to my beloved spiritual master, Om Vishnupada Paramahamsa Pari Vrak Achari Ashtataka Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Sila Narayana Maharaj. Then I offer my humble obeisances unto all the Acharyas in our Guru Varga and unto all the assembled Tridandi, Sannyasis, elevated Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, guests, please accept my humble obeisances. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak on deer. Yeah. What can we learn from deer? What did Dattatreya express here? What he learned from the deer? So the deer is very easily captured by beautiful sound. Hunter plays on flute, and deer very easily comes near, and hunter can shoot the deer. Deer comes near, and hunter catch the deer by sweet music. So here we learn that if we become attracted to mundane musical performances or very sweet sounds, language coming from the mundane realm, very easily we become captured by death. We will be caught in the network of Maya, the material energy. Why? Because this sound, very pleasing to the ear, and we forget what is most important. In human form of life, we are given the very rare, most valuable opportunity to become attracted to our best friend, who is always with us, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. We are looking outside for help, for happiness, for shelter, and we become attracted by our senses. Hearing beautiful sound of any opposite sex, lady or male, we think, oh, how nice this sound. This person is very sweet and attractive. I should meet more intimately with them. And before we know it, captured. And whole life we will spend so many activities we will have to perform and become more and more entangled in the web of Maya. However, becoming very fortunate, coming in contact with Sadhu Sangha, we can overcome this great obstacle. If we become attached to the sound vibration emanating from the lotus lip of the pure sadhu, then, as we have heard many times, maybe not all of you, but we have heard from Sripad Bhagavat Prabhu, by that sound vibration, our heart will be colored with such a beautiful attachment for Krishna, just like the saffron particles. And then everything will become saffron, very beautiful. So that is what we really want. So this we can learn from deer. Be very, very careful. Always come in Sadhu Sangha and become attached to hearing Harikatha. This will save us. Follow Harikatha everywhere in the world. Even if you have no attachment, keep following and one day you'll be attached. Next, the fish.
Fish, yes.
Fish is very eager to taste with its tongue. It wants to always taste something which it sees in its near environment. That is why very easily fishes become hooked. The fisherman, he knows, he puts some bait on the hook and very quickly he catches fishes. So the tongue is the most difficult, voracious to control. By the tongue, we get entangled in so many problems in this world. If we cannot control the tongue, we want to taste so many different preparations in this world. Even devotees, if we come in the path of bhakti, we should be careful. If we overeat, always wanting to taste some good preparation, what will happen? Big belly coming. Pressure, and we will want to enjoy illicit connection with the opposite sex. And then more problems coming. So this is the teachings which we receive from the fish. That we should be very careful to control the tongue.
Oh, this
tongue
has no bone.
No backbone, Gurudev always says.
No bone. It can go everywhere
at any time.
If you will not control, then Mahabharat battle will be. Mahabharat battle will come and finished. Like Sita also, Ravan Yuddha, battle of Ram. Only due to 10, they could not control. That to tell to Duryodhan, oh, blind son is blind.
Like father, like son.
And then, he did a vow, pratigya, that I will take revenge from this lady. And that is why he wanted to make naked. And for that, Bhim promised that I will kill Dushasan, and then by his blood, Draupadi is beaten. When Ram Lakshman Sita were in forest, when Ram was pursuing Marich, a deer, like golden deer, and at the time of day, he called, Oh Lakshman. Then Lakshman, Sita Devi told, oh Ram in danger, you must go. But he denied. Any danger cannot come to Ram. And he is very strong. Any danger cannot come to him. But Sita Devi, he repeatedly told, you should go. Oh, you want to marry me? And Ram should be killed. Then he became, I'm going. But very danger will come. Don't cross this. And when he left, at once Ravana was there, came like a trident sannyasi. Oh, Bhikshang Dehi, like that. And Sita came, I cannot go out of, so please take from here. But he told, I will cause, I am not an ordinary. And by this, she crossed the
line.
When Sita Devi came to Ajodhya, and after so many days, years, when Sita was going in exile, Ram forever kept exile. Then she was weeping and telling, I have done offense to Lakshman. I insulted Lakshman. So I am going to this stage. So always try to control. Be deep. And then Pingala, Shyamrani.
Microphone, please. Om Gyanam Simirani Dasya Gyanam Janasalakaya Chaksurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. First, I offer my unlimited obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Diksha Gurudev, Vichalila Pravishta Om Vishnupad Astotara Satishri Srimanchala Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada, and the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most worshipable Shiksha Gurudev, Om Vishnupad Astotara Satishri Srimanchala Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, to all of our disciplic succession and all the assembled devotees and guests. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak about the next of Dadatreya's 24 gurus, and that is Pingala, the prostitute. From the prostitute, Dadatreya said that he learned that if one has material desires, whether those desires are fulfilled or not, doesn't make any difference. If one has material desires, he'll be very, very unhappy. And if one is free from material desires, then he becomes very happy. Another thing that Dattatreya learned from Pingala is that failure is the pillar of success, if one is sincere about success. Pingala is a prostitute of the city of Videhi. And this prostitute would go out of her house every evening looking for a lover. Not for love, but for money, because this is how she maintained herself. So one night she went out and making very beautiful poses and trying to be very attractive. She was hoping that a lover would come. But the lovers, the men came and left, and nobody came up to her. So she began thinking, maybe this one, maybe that one will think that I'm very beautiful. Oh, that one looks like he has money. Well, that one just passed. But then there's another one. He looks very rich. I'm sure he'll be attracted to me. So thinking and thinking and trying and making all kinds of gestures, nothing was happening. And gradually, midnight came, and she became very, very depressed and disappointed. She became so depressed and so disappointed that somehow or other, detachment entered her heart. Failure can be the pillar of success. So Pingala began to feel detachment and disgust for her own situation. And she spoke very, very instructional words to us. She said, why am I wasting my human form of life just to get some money and sense pleasure from insignificant men? These men themselves are the source of pity. They are the object of pity. And I'm trying to get enjoyment from them. She said, I've uselessly tortured my own soul. Actually, this body, and she began to compare the body, because with detachment comes knowledge. So she began to compare her own body with a building, and the bones being the cross beams and other parts of the body just being structures of the house. And I've just ruined my life just for ordinary, insignificant men who are made of skin and blood and pus and urine, covered by some bodily hairs. And for this, I've ruined my whole life. Actually, the only friend is the friend of all living entities, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who sits in my heart and the heart of everyone. He's the only one that can give happiness to anyone. He's the Lord of the entire creation. Just by a portion of himself, a portion of a portion of a portion of a portion of a portion, he breathes in and out unlimited universes. And we're all within him, and he is within us. So why am I giving my life for something that is only the cause of distress? I spend my days and my night just for sense gratification. Then she began increasing her humility. Of all of Videha, I am the most wretched and the most fallen. Nobody is as abominable as me. And then she became more attached to developing her relationship with Krishna, and she became determined to do that. So then, as she was thinking in this way, all of her disappointment and all of her disgust left, and she became very, very peaceful, as though her desires were satisfied. As Lord Vamandev said, when he was offered by Bali Maharaj, why do you only want three steps of land? I can give you elephants and kingdoms and beautiful women as your wives. So Lord Vamandev said, one who is not satisfied by three steps of land cannot be satisfied by nine islands. One who tries to satisfy his senses beyond what is absolutely needed to maintain body and soul together, he loses all of his brahminical prowess, he loses all of his spiritual strength, and he becomes fully dissatisfied. So, thinking in this way, Pingala went back inside her house and she sat down on her bed and she had a very good night's sleep. Our Srila Prabhupada gives a very interesting example about one very chaste wife whose husband, although she was very chaste and faithful, very good servant, he desired a prostitute. So when she found this out, because she was so chaste, she went to that prostitute's house and began working for her. When the prostitute saw this, she said, you don't realize how expensive I am. So the wife began working more and more, and finally she became a prostitute and made enough money for her husband. When she gave him the money, no gratitude, he just left to went to the prostitute's house. So generally, when someone goes to a prostitute's house, first she gives him an elaborate dinner. And as Brajanath Prabhu just mentioned, when the tongue gets more and more gratified, the belly becomes very full, and then the lusty desires increase. So because this prostitute knew the wife, and she knew what kind of a person this husband was, she served the food in two kinds of containers. One was a brass container, and the other was a golden container. So he sat down, he said, what is this? She said, just taste the preparations, and then tell me what you think. So he tasted the preparation from the gold container and the brass container. She said, well, what do you think? He said, it tastes exactly the same. So she said, yes, you are such a rascal that you don't realize that this taste of sense gratification is exactly the same in myself, in your wife, in the cats and the dogs, and in the demigods. That taste of satisfying one's lusty desires is exactly the same. So in this way, she was able to instruct him. So Pingala is a very good instructor. She accepted failure as the pillar of success. When everything goes wrong, we can take it as Krishna's causeless mercy to become detached from the body. And actually, the Dattatreya even said later that one of my gurus is this body, because no matter how hard I try to please it, it's always dissatisfied and the end is disaster. So we learn from the prostitute Pingala as one of the 24 gurus. Thank you. Thank you for the
Asahi paramam dukham. Nairasyam paramam sukham. Jachind kantasa suswaya pingala. Asahi paramam dukham. Oh, worldly desire. Oh, this is suffering. And detached from worldly desire, oh, there is happiness. And that is why when Pingala, prostitute, oh, gave her everything, all worldly desire, and he became one-pointed to Krishna. Then he became happy and she slept very well, very well. You should.
Pingala ek ratri sadhu seva kore chilo. Sei jonno tar change mind change hoyeche. Nale mind change hoto na.
She has worshipped any good sadhu.
Once.
And perhaps he was Dattatreya.
Yes, I was staying in that house.
Once he was in his house.
It had been written. And that is why. Vanli Sadhu Sangh, Vanli Sadhu Sangh, Vanli. But high class of Sadhu Sangh. Those persons and ladies, even in their old age, going to marry, not satisfied whether they are married 3 times, 4 times, their children, even bogus person, foolish persons, lady and male. What are they doing? Oh, new marriage, bogus. I pray Krishna that you should give them intelligence, that they should be retired from worldly things and they should be happy. Be careful in old age. Don't attach. Detached from worldly desires. This human life is very valuable. Don't lose. And then Bala. Who? Innocent boy? Then you? No need of book, what?
Jnana-chini-dhamsasyam tell. Jnananjana-shlakaya Chakshuran-militang-jena Tasmai-shigra-deva-ha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa-sandhubhyavacha Utitanam-bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo-namaha. Srila Gurudev has instructed me to speak about the Dattatreya, what he's learned from the innocent child, the foolish child. So, parents, adults, they take so much trouble to provide themselves with money, with a house, good food, refrigerator, motor car, washing machine, CD players, nice ones, computer, all these things. To do this, they have to work very, very hard. In material life, they have to work hard like animals on a treadmill. You know, they have the bull is crushing, or they have on this treadmill. They're working so hard in a job that they hate, which has got no connection with real life at all. It's just part of an artificial system. And then, with that money, then they buy useless things, which are actually no use for real life also. And in this way, they're spending the whole of their lives just to maintain themselves in society. So the man comes home exhausted, 8 o'clock at night, and the child is there. He says, oh, daddy, give me money. So the child is, he's not got any duties, anything. But he's enjoying quite happily. No arrangements at all. So actually, we're all living in the lap, in the hand of Krishna. And Krishna's providing. Sometimes he's providing a lot, sometimes he's providing a little. So Dattatreya explained that there's two kinds of people who are happy in this world. One is the foolish, innocent child who takes no trouble for his own maintenance, but he's maintained by parents without any trouble at all. And the other one is Paramahansa. Everybody else is so much problems, struggling so much for sense gratification, struggling so much for survival. The animals, they're living quite happily. The foolish child is also living happily. So this is the lesson that if we simply accept what is coming by Krishna's grace, by Gurudev's grace, and learn to become satisfied with that. Sometimes we want more than comes. Then we should understand that this is a lesson that actually we want more, but we need less. Or maybe we need to learn how to make do with less, to be happy and contented with less. Hare Krishna.
Govinda Prabhu, Kumari, young lady. Where? Govinda Prabhu?
coming.
Not here?
Yeah, she's coming.
Where's sitting?
She's sitting in the back.
Young lady.
Young lady has visitors at her home, so she thinks immediately, I have to make some preparation, some offering in order to be hospitable. She has bangles on her arms, so she disappears into the kitchen in order to create some offering and satisfy her guests. But she doesn't want them to know that she's back there in the kitchen doing all the work on the spur of the moment, so her bangles, which are clashing together, are making noise. So she thinks, oh, they'll know what I'm doing if the bangles are making so much noise. Therefore, I better get rid of the bangles. And of course, she picks one bangle, crushes, throws it. Another bangle crushes until she has two bangles on each arm. She thinks, okay, now I'm good, but she begins working, and again, noise, just because of two bangles. Therefore, she finally takes one bangle off of each wrist and leaves one on. One bangle can't clash against anything else, and no noise is coming, and she's able to accomplish her task. And what is this? What's the lesson teaching? That. What is the lesson? Oh, yeah. It was a great story. So, like, if a person lives with so many others, then there'll be clashing discussions and difficulty in talking. So much prajalpa will create political unrest. Therefore, if we rid ourselves of that prajalpa, that clashing of bangles, what's the solution? Living alone. Nobody to clash with. This, of course, doesn't mean nirjan. This doesn't mean with no one. It means living with like-minded svajatiya, snigdasya devotees who are kindly disposed towards you and who have the same mood. Then there'll be no fighting, no problem, no prajalpa, only pure Hari Katha.
Thank you. Okay. Don't think Nirjan means without anyone, alone. No. At all. But Swajati Snigda Ashaya Vaishnavasa. This is also called Nirjan. If you will think that Nirjan Bhajan, then you will have to do the associate with elephant and
tigers,
bears, and all animals, or trees,
mosquito,
and so many things. Very good. Arrow maker. Radhakant.
Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnananjana Savakaya Chakshurun Viritam Jinatas Mayi Sri Guruve Namah. First of all, I offer my humble obeisances to the lotus feet of Shishima Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Swami Maharaj, my Diksha Guru, Prabhupada Guru Varga, to Tri Dandi Sannyasi Gan, all Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, and guests, right, respects to the audience.
But he's telling, don't ask me.
There was once an arrow maker who fashioned by wood very long straight arrows with sharp points. This was his occupation. One day, he was engaged in his trade, and a huge procession came by, the king. Whenever a Maharaj goes out, they're usually followed by many, many big retinue of guards, people playing music, sometimes holding umbrella, elephants, horses, kettle drums, very big procession. Because he's an important person, huh? A Maharaj, a king, so he never goes alone. At this time, the king was passing by, and this huge tumultuous sound was going on. The arrow maker was fixed in his occupation, so much so that he didn't even notice or hear anything from the king's procession. So we know that this means that a devotee or a sadhak who is one-pointed in our bhakti, engaged in sravanam, kirtanam, vishnu smaranam, hearing, chanting, remembering, or doing various types of practical services, archanam, padasevanam, dasyam, sakyam, atmanivedanam, or serving in so many different ways, if our mind is absorbed in our service, in our Gurudev, in Krishna, then we're not seeing so many allurements and beautiful things of this world to attract us into Maya. So the arrow maker is this example of a person who can be completely fixed. And even though there is a large disturbance, something that would normally attract the mind of someone, he is not disturbed. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Vishayavinivartante niraharashadehina raso savarjam raso vyasya param drishtva nivartate. And even if a person controls his senses, we're talking about all the different senses, even one sense, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, if we become attached to it, it can carry us away. The tongue, the sight, everything. So, if we don't become distracted, and with our sadhya, our goal fixed in mind, doing our sadhana, our practice in Krishna consciousness, then param drishtva nivartate, we will get some higher taste, and from that higher taste, we can remain fixed in consciousness. One thing about the fish that I wanted to mention was that the fish is so attached to the taste of palatable food that he becomes captured. In the purport, there's some commentary that in Krishna consciousness, we have 12 rasas, 5 primary rasas and 7 secondary rasas. And these rasas are transcendental bhavs or feelings and emotions combined with the different ingredients of rasa that create an extraordinary taste in the heart and mind of the sadhak. So, if one goes to Vrindavan and traverses the 12 forests, each forest represents one rasa. If we do parikram of Vrindavan, or if we're hearing about the wonderful pastimes of Krishna in Vrindavan and all these forests, then these different moods and tastes will come. So by experiencing this higher taste, or by being fixed in consciousness, just like the arrow maker was very fixed in consciousness, he was not attracted by Maya, he was not disturbed, and he was able to perform his duty perfectly.
Very good. Oh, thank you. Very good. So, told that I make my Shiksha Guru snake. Why Bhagavat Prabhu?
Don't take a
sleep. Om Gyan Timirandasya. Yananjana salakaya chakshuranulitam yena tasmai sri guruve namaha.